Okay, next up is Thibaut with Cellular. Welcome, Thibaut.
Hi. Okay, I'm Thibaut. Let's talk about logging. I'm assuming most everybody here has used some kind of logging library at some point, or maybe probably even you've written your own. And query looks like that, some kind of formatting thing, like really some kind of extension on top of printf formatting or printf debugging, really. And then we probably ended up with this choice, loads of text like that, and some log file somewhere hidden on the server. And that's really fine. I mean, the human eye can really just draft patterns in there until someday, so that he just shows up and will ask you, ah, yeah, but then we just do me a list of all the customers for which we have this log entry with this volume of this time amount of loading and stuff. And you're like, crap. I mean, I know regular expressions, but you know. And here you are trying to extract your data from your log files when you really just had it in the first place pretty well separated from your log statement. So that's kind of the idea to go to beyond text-based login, where you're really writing just log messages, just big blocks of strings all over the place. Is to go towards structured logging, where you're not writing log messages, but logging events. So it's really just kind of key value collections of information, more like JSON-y kind of stuff. So the idea with that is you will just start logging kind of the same way. You have your logging statements, except instead of throwing away straight away the data you're formatting, you kind of keep it around you. You keep it around, you capture it. So instead of doing string F formatting, you're actually storing the structure with the structure of the data all along with the level you're logging with the message template. So you can see it properly. But you're really waiting until the last minute to actually format it into a log message, a log event. And once you have that in place, actually, it's pretty cool because you defer rendering until the end. So you can still, if you want, somehow decide to format at the last minute into some kind of log file. But you can actually use this structured data you've been storing and store it in a store that supports more powerful things. Like, for instance, a document store where you will just store all that thing and be able to query it later on. Or you can store that in actually some kind of hybrid storage, like a relational database that has support for JSON querying or XML querying or structured data thing. Or just store it in Elasticsearch, store it in a, you name it. Or on some sort of specific log server. So the idea is that once you have actually this information stored with your events, you can actually use tools to query it. And what's really interesting later on, once you have your big walls, lots of events, you can start doing really useful stuff with all these properties you've been storing appending to your events. You can do lots of correlation stuff, like just give me all the events related to the same HTTP request under my web server. You can correlate and track the moves of your users in your system. That's really pretty cool. So it's just really a quick introduction to structured data logging. In my case, I'm here to promote a bit like Serilog. It's a .NET library that works cross-platform, a bit more than 650 million downloads. Oh yeah, that's .NET open source community. I don't know if you heard about that. Sorry, this. If you want more, go to our website or GitHub repo and if you ask questions. I'm Thibaut. Thank you for listening. That's it.
Thank you very much. 6:10.